ABC is a catalyst for healthier and wealthier communities. Joining us today is Diane Bell McKoy, President and CEO of Associated Black Charities. Welcome, Diane. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
Absolutely. This is such a great organization. Tell us more about what are some of the ways ABC is making a difference in Maryland and people's lives.
Well, first of all, we're a public foundation. And as it says, we're really a bottom line is about how do we change the economic outcomes in the state of Maryland. So the first thing on that agenda is how do we help people connect to both work in terms of in career paths. And so we actually put grants out in terms of a number of our nonprofit training providers, and our focus is not just on training, but on employment. So we hold some of the grant back until the person's employed.
You say a key word there, employment. Such a tough economy right now, and there are people that are so well qualified but still not finding jobs. So what are you doing to make a difference there?
Well, the difference I think is in the innovation that's involved in our nonprofit grantees that are out there making difference, connecting to employers, but they all have one thing in common. Their customer is the employer, is the business. And in many cases, they are partnering with businesses who are very clear they have vacancies, but they want to make sure they get the right person for the job. So we pay attention to low income in terms of how do we connect people of color to those career path opportunities and make sure they're ready. But we're also now paying attention to professional in terms of people of color. How do we get them connected to those vacancies that people really want, a much more diverse workforce, and say they have a hard time connecting to that?
And what is it like to be able to fulfill that type of role in people's lives? I mean, it is life-changing when you're able to be employed.
For me, it is really what it is all about for both Associated Black Charities and for me personally. Mm-hmm. It is always about how do you help people improve not just their lives, but when you help get somebody who's traditionally been unemployed for a long period of time, particularly a number of men, we've been very successful getting them employed who have been very low skilled, but opportunity to grow those skills. What you're actually doing is helping a family. And so you're helping more than just that individual. You're helping to make a difference for the family, entire family, in terms of their being contributing citizen to this region. And that makes a difference for all of us.
Absolutely. Tell us more about your road to success and a little bit about your background and how you got to where you are now.
I have a friend that once described in terms of calls me that I'm always going to be a social worker. And I would say that I'm really about being an economic social worker. I've always been concerned and focused on how do you make a difference in people's lives so they can make a difference for their families. But what's that about? What is it about for, particularly for people of color, who don't necessarily aren't connected to the opportunities, who aren't connected to having access to making a difference? And so that's really been my pathway from being in nonprofit sector when I first came out of graduate school to going inside of government and the District of Columbia and Baltimore. That has always been the focus. How do you make a difference? How do you connect people to other people? Because that's a part of the very powerful part of making a difference, recognizing that people don't necessarily know what they don't know. And so that's always been the way I've gone forward in my career.
Mm-hmm. And you obviously share something that the other two guests have, which is passion for what you do and just wanting to make a difference, which is really what you need in this type of career.
I absolutely believe that. I would not. My going to the job every day for me is really not going to a job. I tell people very clearly that I'm clear that this is my mission. I'm clear this is God-led for me, that everything that I've done in my career has led me to this point. I trust that the rest of what I will do, that I will continue to be guided and led in that direction. Because when you can see, not just whether it's employment, but higher education in terms of when you can see people actually change their lives and then change the community around them because they've made a difference economically, that says a whole lot for not just the Baltimore region, but for this country.
Let's talk a little bit about your gala coming up.
Absolutely.
This is a big event. Tell us more about it. It's the 2012 annual gala on Saturday, June 9th.
Absolutely.
Right? And tell us what it's all about.
Well, we're going to be celebrating and lifting up African Americans who made a difference in the community, who are from the corporate community. We're honored in terms of our honorary co-chairs this year. We're very honored. We have a senior vice president from Lockheed Martin, Linda Gooden.
Wonderful.
And the other co-chair is Ron Daniels, the president of Hopkins.
Okay.
And that's the message we want to give to people in terms of come out, celebrate, it's a party with a purpose. And we'll be honoring a number of African-American professionals in the region who are making a difference. Because it's important to have people understand that philanthropy can be used to make a difference and a change in people's lives.
We have about a minute left, but I just want you to share any short story that you have about a life that you've touched, somebody that's come back to you just to say thank you.
Well, actually, there are several, obviously, but one that I remember very vividly because it just happened about a week ago in terms of it was one of our young professionals, actually, who got attached to a board as a result of going through our board training in terms of for African-American Latino professionals. And that person was struggling in terms of how they could make a difference and then had a career. She lost a job. And through that network and through the ability to connect with people she had never had the opportunity in this region to see, not only did she land employment, she was accepted in terms of also making a decision to go back to school in terms of education. That's the difference.
That's why you do what you do.
Absolutely.
Thank you so much. It's been a pleasure getting
to know
you. Thank you
for having me.
Absolutely.